In this episode, we'll be reviewing the Celestron Firstscope. Right, so let's open the box. This telescope is a simple Dobsonian design. However, unlike large Dobsonian telescopes, it requires a flat surface in order to use it. Preferably something like a tabletop. As this is a Dobsonian telescope, it's quite simple to use. Just point at the target you wanted to record and then look through the eyepiece here. This telescope has a 76mm aperture, which is about 3 inches, and it has a 300mm focal length, which means it is quite fast if you're doing any photography for it, if you're wearing a wide field view, unless you had an intervening eyepiece in there. And that comes out at f3.9 if you're interested. So this telescope doesn't come with a finder scope, which I found quite a bit more difficult to use at first when I tried it out. But it does actually come with the attachments, so there are actually some finder scope screws just here. So if you're going to use this, obviously if you're going to use it as it is, you recommend your way would be to use the 20mm eyepiece that it comes with to find the target and then zoom in with the 4mm eyepiece if you're going to do so, increase the magnification with the 4mm eyepiece. So this comes with two Kilmer eyepieces, which is in this box here. That is out of the way. So you get two eyepieces of this, the 20mm eyepiece, which gives you 15 times magnification, and the 4mm, which gives you 75 times magnification. Now, these are Kellner eyepieces, so they only have a 40 to 50 degree apparent field of view when you look through them, which isn't great. So a good upgrade if you've got, if you're thinking about upgrade, would be a Plossel eyepiece, not very expensive, but it'll give you 52 degrees apparent field of view, which will widen what you see when you look out into the night sky. And a great thing about as well, if you do upgrade to the Plossel eyepieces, you'll be able to take them to any other telescope you've got. So if you upgrade to a new telescope in the future, then you can just use it in that telescope as well. Now, the maximum magnification you can usually use for a telescope is 50 times magnification per inch of aperture. Now this is 3 inches, so you should be able to go up to 150 magnification, but you're not going to get much smaller than a 4mm eyepiece. So to get to the full 150 times magnification you can get out of this telescope, you'll need a Barlow lens, a 2x Barlow lens. But again, I would recommend getting to a Plossel eyepiece if you need to do that, because the Kellner eyepieces just aren't really that great to high magnifications. However, at the magnifications they've got, so 75 times magnification and 15 times magnification, I found that these eyepieces did actually perform adequately in this scope, giving quite sharp images. So actually use a eyepiece on this telescope. You just want to take off the cap here, pop in an eyepiece, fasten it up with the tightening knobs here, and focus like so. So, who's this telescope good for? Well, due to its small size, you can pack it down to pretty much nothing, so it's a great travel telescope. It's also quite a good telescope for someone who only uses a telescope now and again, not a particularly serious observer. You can take it out for small, events that you see in the media. Another good thing this telescope's for is small children, because it's got a great compact size. They can easily get around it and use it. It's not very difficult to use, very simple operation, so it's great for a small child. Well, I hope you found that review interesting. If you have any questions, then please leave them in the comments below. If you like the video, give us a like. And if you'd like to see more astronomy videos, then please do subscribe. Goodbye and clear skies.